Okay, everybody, I have a bit of an interesting one for you. Took me a few minutes to figure this concept out, so I thought I would show you as well. We're going to start my game, if it'll let me, and go in and show you how when we retrieve a gold coin, that we can do something to our health or shields, actually, for that matter. So let's check that out. So we've got a timer that starts the game. And off we go. Now, this is a new game that I've been working on, just kind of playing around with some ideas, some concepts on how to do things. And so you guys are seeing sort of a preview of that. So we're gonna see this guy here and take him out. Now he's got 500 health, so, and he's a good shot. Okay, so that's that. Now, as you can see, I've taken some hits, and there's another guy here. Oh, I'm out of bullets. Okay. So in we go, in this room here is a coin. Now you can see that my health is at 53, and I have zero shield. So when I retrieve this coin, I get 100 health. So we're going to check out how to trigger something based off of picking up a coin, or picking up anything for that matter. In this case, a coin. Okay, so here we are in UEFN, and I've just opened the project, and I wanted to give you guys a quick tip if you don't know it already. It's kind of useful, but if you're zoomed way, way out and you don't remember where everything is, or you know, you got a big map or something like that, select something in your outliner and then hit the letter F on your keyboard, and we'll take you right to that thing. So here we are in the map. We've got, of course, the camera is moving at light speed for some reason. It's a bug, I think. It's one of those things that drives me nuts. Anyways, I digress. So what we want to do is we want to collect a coin, right? So let's go inside of here. We can see we've got an item spawner. An item spawner is a device that allows you to make an item show up. So if we go into the Fortnite devices down in the content browser, and we do a search for item spawner, and here's our item spawner. So item spawner is literally just something that makes a thing. So if we click on it, we can actually see over on the right hand side, we have in our item list, we have just a gold item. And you can put anything in here. You can put an acorn, you can put bullets, you can put guns, anything you want. Anything that's in Fortnite will kind of show up here. I used a coin. So when this coin is grabbed, we want to capture that event. But unfortunately, item spawners are kind of useless for Verse. Epic hasn't done a lot of coding, I guess, for the item spawner, where we can capture that the item has been picked up with Verse, and we really, really want to do that. I mean, using Verse for everything is what we want, because it makes things easier and better, and life is better and everything. So inside of my game manager, I've got my code that does this. So we're going to take a look at this in just a second. But the first thing that we have to do is set it up so that this item spawner can trigger a thing, and there's a clue there, that we can actually respond to in Verse. So just outside here, we can see, where did I put it? Okay, so right here is our trigger device, and this trigger device is something that we can listen to in Verse. If we select it and then head down into its parameters here, we can see that we can set a trigger up for a thing. Now, I've got three item spawners, three coins to go get, so that's why there's three things in here. But if we want to put a new one in here, so we'll add a new one, it says none. And then inside of here, we can have some kind of thing that goes on. So I do know that it's an item spawner that I want to respond to. So if I select item spawner, and inside of here, it will say on item pickup. We're going to use the event that happens from the trigger inside of Verse to make a thing happen to our character. So let's do that. There we go, delete. Okay, so let's head into Verse. Okay, so inside of Verse, if you don't know how to make a game manager, then check out one of my other tutorials. I'll link below on how to create one of these things. I'm not going to do it in this one because there's just so much going on. But essentially, a game manager is what I have as a basic class, create a device that has all of the things that I want to do. And you can make more of these, but this is for my game, for my management of my game. So inside of here, we want to make an editable for the trigger for the coin. And this is a trigger device. So a trigger device is exactly what we looked at here. This is a trigger device. And we're going to make this available to our console here, our game manager. This device right here, this is our game manager. We just drag this game manager thing onto the stage or the scene, and it will show up. And we want to tell the game manager what trigger we want to use for the thing. So inside of our code, we make an editable. And when you make something an editable, it means you can add it on the stage, connect things up. So I've called mine coin trigger. It's a trigger device, and I instantiate it here. So now that it's an editable, if we select this, head over into our details panel, you can see way down here, coin trigger, and I've set it to be the trigger. There's only one trigger in this whole game, so that's what's going to show up in here. It's dependent on the type of device that we have set up inside of Verse. So inside of Verse, we have trigger device. So UEFN is smart enough to figure that out. So now that we've got the trigger device, because we can't listen to anything on the item spawner, there's nothing to listen to in Verse, and we want to do everything via Verse. So the coin trigger, so let's go find where we do something with this, which is right here in the on begin. So we just do the triggered event. And if you're wondering how to find these things, you're like, well, what kind of events have we actually, how do you even know? If you go up to this trigger device, hold control and click on it, you'll go into the trigger device here inside of the Fortnite digest verse file. And this is what's available to us as developers. And the triggered event is the public subscribable or listenable event that happens when a thing happens. You can also cause it to be triggered, which is kind of interesting, based on another thing that you do, and then that will trigger a thing. So triggers are very, very cool. You can do all kinds of stuff. So we're going to listen. So we set up the trigger device here. We go down here and we set up the event to happen. So this is how we're getting an item spawner to trigger a thing inside of Verse. Very, very useful. And then way down here on coin pickup. So I thought I would cover this briefly because it's kind of important. You want to be able to access the character that did the thing. The triggered event is triggered by an agent, and it would be the agent that makes it happen, which is you in theory. And so it's going to be questionable. Is this actually an agent? Is it going to fail or not? So that's why we put in this question mark. It might come back as failed. If it does, then we just do nothing. So what we want to do in my game, I'm setting coins gathered to +1. So ignore this. It doesn't really matter. We want to check to see if the agent is an actual agent. And it's you do that really simply by making a variable name, in this case, valid agent, colon equals agent question mark. And then this is an if statement. So on the end of that goes a colon. And essentially it's saying, hey, is this coming back with an object, with coming back with an agent? It's not actually checking for agent. But it's checking to say that it doesn't come back as false, because it's either going to come back with an agent object or false. So if this validates as some form of true, then do a thing. And so the thing that we're going to do is we're going to get the Fortnite character object, and that we can get from the agent, which I called valid agent, and get Fort character with a couple of brackets on the end. And then from there, I check to see, is my health at 100? If so, set the shield to 100. If it isn't, only set the health. Good luck, carry on. And then we check to see if we've gathered all the coins, and in such a case, activate the end game device. But we'll get into that in another tutorial. But I wanted to show you guys how you can react from an item spawner, because you can't do this in Verse, to go to a trigger, which you can react to in Verse. Epic has done enough work there. Connect it up to your game manager, your device, whatever you want to call it, that manages your game code. And then inside of there, access it through the verse coding. So kind of simple, yet it takes a little bit of time to figure all that out. So I thought I'd put that out there. And hopefully that's useful. Any questions or comments, let me know. And that ends this one. So I'll see you guys in the next one.